Hey team, thanks so much for joining me for today's session. The purpose of this video is to talk to you about some of the resources that I use here in my home during this distance learning experience.
It dawned on me that you might be curious what tools I use as I equip teachers from a distance learning perspective, because I'm teaching and training them how to provide services to their students that are also in a distance learning environment.
Item number one is an HDMI cable. If you would like to use a free second screen for your computer, like you want to use your computer, but man, you wish you could see something a little bit bigger, or the sound was a little bit better, or you wanted a second place. For me, I use a two-screen workflow. So if you want a free second screen, you're more than welcome to just use any HDMI cable that you currently have in your own home. Plug it into your computer, plug the other end into your television, and voila, you now have a second screen. And if you're just using an HDMI cable that you have at home, then it's free. This is a free way that you can instantly have a second screen. Now, if you're not sitting next to a television where it's convenient for you to instantly have that free second screen, well, then you can always purchase a portable second screen. And you don't have to spend $200 on a portable screen. However, this is the model and the type of portable screen that I use because I actually take my screen with me. For this one, there's actually a magneted cover, and the magneted cover not only covers the screen while you're in transport, but then it also becomes a stand once you arrive at that second location. And this is a resource that I can't live without. I might design a teaching video on one screen and I have email on the other screen, or I'm working on a PowerPoint on one screen, but I want to look at a PDF on that second screen. It just gives me the ability to look at more things at the same time. When I purchased this over a year ago, the cable that it came with, in my opinion, did not function properly. So after I made this purchase, I actually went back onto Amazon and then I purchased a better USB-C cable. Now, you need to make sure that your computer has a USB-C port in order to make sure that you're purchasing the right screen. Let me say up front that I'm not going to promise that any of these resources will work on your computer. It's going to be your responsibility to evaluate whether or not your computer can handle or work with any of these resources. I'm just telling you from experience the resources that work for me. Down here, you'll notice that there are options where you can choose different cabling options. So evaluate, talk to someone, see what works best for you and your computer. Here's another resource that I use. Anytime I design a video, I am always using this microphone. Anytime I'm on a Zoom session or I'm video conferencing with someone, I always use this. I ask people on the other end, hey, does my internal microphone sound lovely, or does it sound better when I use the microphone? Hands down, everyone says that when I plug the microphone in, the audio quality is so much better. It's not mandated. It's not necessary. Your computer already has a microphone. But if you would like the quality of that microphone to increase, this is the resource that I recommend. The computer that I use already has a stylus. I did not need to purchase one. Tucked into the side of my computer, it's almost invisible to the naked eye, but I know it's there and I can pop out a stylus and use it. However, if your computer did not come with a stylus and you would like one, this is one option for you. Most of you probably have a touch screen and your finger will work just fine on the screen. In my opinion, I have far more control over what I'm writing when I use a stylus. So feel free to see if this one would work for you. If not, there are several other styluses that are out on the market that would probably work fine on your computer as well. This is another purchase that I made recently, maybe in the ballpark of April of 2020. And I originally purchased a different mouse because I wanted something that was ergonomic, and that one just didn't cut it. And then I upgraded to this one. Because I spend 10 hours a day on my computer and I'm using my mouse a lot, My wrist was quite sensitive and my hand was hurting at the end of the day. And the little trackpad that's available on my computer, in my opinion, just isn't perfect for how much I do on the computer. I personally recommend this resource. Yes, I know it's almost $100 after tax and shipping and handling, but I have not been disappointed with this resource. The trackball on the left-hand side, I use my thumb in order to cause the arrow on my computer to move around in order to make those adjustments that I normally would with the movement of my wrist. Right now, my arm and my wrist are able to stay stationary the entire time, and it's only my thumb that's moving in order to make choices on the computer. I still have the left click and the right click. There was a small muscle learning curve that I needed to execute because I was so used to doing things differently. It was frustrating at first for about the first 3 weeks. And now through muscle retraining, memory retraining, muscle and memory retraining, my hand and my brain are now interacting perfectly. It's like I've always used it. So this is a tool that I recommend. For this video, this is the last tool that I'm going to talk about. I personally do not own the device that you see on the screen right here. I was able to find something locally from a store for $5. If you are the type of person where you're going to use your cell phone to create YouTube videos of yourself, this resource might be helpful for you. If you're not going to use your cell phone, if you're not going to post videos on YouTube of yourself, then you don't need to worry about this. You can certainly achieve this through other resources. If you want to use internal software within your own computer, you're more than welcome to do that. This is only for individuals who are going to create YouTube videos of themselves. You might want something that's going to elevate that cell phone so that the lighting is excellent, the angle is perfect, and you have good eye contact with your cell phone. The other time you would use a resource like this is if you are on a Zoom session and you want your cell phone to function like a document camera. If you use your cell phone as a second user, for example, you're zooming from your computer, you're also zooming from your iPhone, but your iPhone is pointed down to the table from an elevated fashion, maybe you would like to use your cell phone as that document camera. And whenever you want, you can switch that presenter view from either you, the teacher, or over to that document camera. A resource similar to this might be effective. I'm not sure exactly how elevated, how stretched up, how high this particular tripod would work, but that's another reason why you would use a resource like this. That is the last tool that I'm going to recommend in this video. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.